first command. Sounds like I see it finna. Hey, I'm on your turf again. This, that, yeah. From the back of the I got a girl, right? Yeah. She go to battle. LED glow to the tank. Yeah. I go in back of the they all from that. Yeah. My diamonds, they all look good. This, that, yeah. I go to bed on bed. I got a beam in the flex. Yeah. I got a in the back. Haters, they talk to chat. Check. They step on the rock, I'm at. I'm a K-Vet, 100K, I found out where you lay at, I got the lurking, and they hate cats, pockets stay fat, I got the from the block and they scamming, they know where banks at, I got the work on the avenue, they know where tanks at, I got the live in the mansion, they know where that, I got some that's up in the jail and they know where that, I came on top of the building, yeah, my we had a plan, we came on top of the building, yeah, my we never ran, down there, thought that I had a fan. Any 10 o'clock, got a flight out. Yeah, I'm going back out to Japan. I got two Billy truck and a bitch door with a land. Bruce Wayne, I'm Batman. Batman, I'm best man. I got my best man. I got my. I go to hotels when I step out. Yeah, your boy got a doorman. I go to nightclubs for the. Yeah, they call me the madman. I ain't no madman. I just go crazy, man. Ball hard, can't face, man. Choppers, rip wasteland. This what happens when you give it a taste life, then you give it a wasteland. This what happens when you give it a fake life, then the ape, man. I live with birds, man. Sounds like I see it in that. Hey, I'm on your turf again. This, that, yeah. From the back of the. I got a girl, Brett. Yeah. She put a battle, she. Yeah. I live with birds, man. Sounds like I see it in that. Hey, I'm on your turf again. This, that, yeah. From the back of the. I got a girl, Brett. Yeah. She go to battle, she.
Pulling up in that new toy, the wrist on that boy, rock star like Pink Floyd. Waving at rude boy, I'm waving at you boy. Ran off on the two like true goy. Imagine me, dude boy, you can never do what I do, boy. Still ducky that I did, boy. In Paris for a hit, boy. These ain't the same type of hits, boy. Can get, boy. You don't take these type of risks, boy. Cause this boy been throwing that like rich, boy. You miss, boy. Your numbers don't add up on the. That was 10 years ago. If you know, you know. Yeah.
Get it, Tom.
If you know, you know. You know, you know. This thing of ours, oh, this thing of ours. A fraternity of bringing off. I just happen to be alumni. Too legit, they still looking at me with one eye. The company I keep is not corporate enough. Child, you ain't often enough. A rapper turn can't morph into us. But turn rapper can't
Mio.
Morph into puff. Dance contest for the.
All right, coach, from one of the loudest venues in the NFL, there's a look at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. The scene just a few moments ago, predictably loud and raucous here at Arrowhead as their beloved Chiefs took field, and they are set to match up with the Baltimore Ravens. Two teams trying to stake their claim to postseason football. Week 14 of the NFL is underway. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take this one to the 25, call it the 26-yard line. He'll be brought down about the 28.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Across the 30 to the 31-yard line. Zadarius Smith able to get him down.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. Nice play for Kansas City, picking up the first 18 yards that time.
Partner, it's not often that I expect running backs to eclipse 100 yards in back-to-back games, but he left 100 way behind last week. I think he's going to do it again. I'm expecting 150 or more.
And last week, AFC Offensive Player of the Week. So if he does what you say he might, maybe he'll get another one.
Yeah, I think he's locked in.
Mahomes going to hand it off to Hunt. And across midfield, he goes into Raven territory. A gain of three, second down.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth so far. Four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. That one good for 12 yards into Kansas City first. Now it's Hunt. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. The former Charger All-Pro, Eric Weddle, on the stop.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
Second down, Hill. An 11-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Chiefs first down. A lot of running backs, a little bit of a disadvantage when you start talking MVP. Might not be the case this year. You think he's got a shot, don't you?
I do. I think he's got more than a shot. But what he's going to need here down the stretch this late in the season, he needs that big closing game, that game that we're all going to reflect on and go, oh, my goodness, did he put up a number, let's say 200-plus?
It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. So they get half of what they needed. It'll be third and six upcoming.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters around the space in the run fits. And there's creases like they were able to exploit right there.
They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Only a yard that time, second and goal. They get it to him running left. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the four-yard line. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, but now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this four down territory? Might he go for it?
Line of scrimmage at the four. Here's third and goal. Shotgun snap to Mahomes.
Ooh.
And this is going to be incomplete. The linebacker, C.J. Mosley, there in coverage.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. They run. It's Hill. And he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. Tyreek Hill taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Chiefs take it right down and score on the opening drive.
Well, these guys have won three straight ball games and another good start to this one after the 6-0 lead.
And I've talked with so many different coaches, as have you along the way, and they always talk about winning streaks and the mood
game
of the team.
Game time, baby.
And how much easier it is to actually prepare during that time. Guys are sharp, guys are focused, everyone's feeling good, and we're seeing it early in this one.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. On the ground with their leading rusher from a season ago, it's Alex Collins. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
All right, now look at 56.
Now Jackson on second down. Man open left side. It's Williams. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. It's a pickup of 11 and a Baltimore first down. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you'd gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
Watch it now, Barney, Barney! Gun, gun! Gun, gun!
On first and 10, it's Jackson.
Mm.
It's brought in here by
I hate
Lewis
that play. Every fucking time.
This one down almost all the way to the 30. A good pickup there, 22.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
On second down, here's Jackson. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Ron Parker there in on the coverage, and he knocked it away.
I haven't seen more of them trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
On third down, Jackson. And it's complete. It's Alex Collins. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. The Raven passing game getting in sync. Another first down.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner. But to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding?
Mijo, siete.
It's a big third down pickup to keep their drive alive.
It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. Second down, Jackson. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Chris Jones able to drop him for a loss of four. Under four to play now. Clock running. Third down.
Detroit! All right, now look at 56.
Jackson from the shotgun. This is They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him, as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. That little
got a man, it's caught.
I couldn't adjust.
Ravens touchdown. Max Williams, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game.
Hey, boy, I'm going to whoop your butt. Stop jumping in the bed.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And the Chiefs now getting set to go. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive helmet.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
He's going to loft one deep left side here. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Line of scrimmage, again, the 25, second and 10. Now a 10th carry for Hill. He finds an opening past the 40. That one good for 33 and a first.
Outside handoff to the right side. If you're a running back, you love getting the ball early, so you have vision to see what's happening
hey,
in front
sit
of you.
Down.
Right tackle likes that call. Big play for him, but don't forget about the guys you always tell me on the backside sealing off.
Well, they talk about cutoff blocks, making sure no one can leak from the backside that can run a play down.
Yeah, nobody leaked. Big play. Got a play fake here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. And incomplete, he dropped it in the end zone.
They went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
Mahomes again here on second and 10. Flush to his right. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage here. Going down back at the 28. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Hey, sit down.
2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. We're back to Arrowhead after this. They stay on the ground. This time it's Hill, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go. You talked about the need for them to establish the run early. They've been able to do that here in the first half.
And that means that the whole offense has adopted that attitude and that persona. We're going to take care of this young quarterback. Let's all get together and run it and take the pressure off.
They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. Now a first down carry. It's Hill. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. And now the Raven defense going to call a timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Second down, Hill, and he couldn't quite get there, tackled down at the one. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
This guy's well on his way now to a big game on the ground. It's another good run there. Puts him over the century mark in yardage, and we're still in the second quarter.
They'll give it to him up the middle. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
I don't know about you, Brandon, but I often think to myself, in these situations, I want a back who can create his own space, who can break tackles, and in a sense, become his own blocker. We don't have that guy in the game right now.
They'll try to run with Hunt, and he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down. So now it's third and goal. This Raven defense trying to keep him out of the end zone. This is Hunt. What a stand so far defensively, and now that's going to bring up a fourth and goal. A field goal would break the tie, but look at this. Instead, they're going to go for it on fourth and goal. Here we go with Hill. And he's going to take it into the end zone for a chance touchdown. Tyreek Hill in the final seconds of the first half. And the Chiefs are in for six.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Rolled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
Well, just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. The point after is good, and that makes the score 14-7. This is taken at his four. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. And now here come the Ravens. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10. They'll start on the ground with Montgomery. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. On second down, Collins. He juked him. And he's going to be taken down here as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play. And now due to apparent time constraints, we fast forward to the beginning of the second half. Ready for the start of the third quarter. The Chiefs have the lead and set to receive the football. And he'll take this across the 25.
Lay down, boy.
Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line.
Shit.
Out come the Ravens now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Ooh. He gets this one to Michael Crabtree. First catch of the game for Crabtree. It's a first down.
Detroit!
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Throwing now, Jackson on first down. And he's taken down. A Chiefs sack. Allen Bailey in there to get him. And that's sack number 6 for him on the year. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. Throwing is Jackson. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Collins. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. A big one there for the Ravens. It goes for 18.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Here's a first down run with Collins. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Another nice game, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
This stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of their yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run. And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Again, left side to Collins. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive room right here.
Jackson, eluding the pressure right. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. They run with Collins. They'll be brought down at the 21 after a pickup of four.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety, being able to hit people with a run in the pass. But in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. They're not going to throw it or they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU most valuable unit, but you're right. It might go to them in this game.
I like that. MVU. Well done.
So on fourth down, here's the Ravens Pro Bowl kicker, Justin Tucker, out onto the field. On the left hash mark, this a 38-yard attempt. And Tucker's kick right there. It's good. And they'll cut the lead back down to four now at 14-10. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, Parker, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting three? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find ones that get you into the end zone, get you six?
So here's the Chiefs offense ready for their first reps in half number two. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
They'll begin the drive with Hunt. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out. And by a few inches, that'll be a first down.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor.
Hey, sit down, boy.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. And once again, Hill, he's been busy. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Oftentimes when a guy has a game like this, he's going to take his offensive line out to dinner afterwards. But after a play like that, he may tell him, instead of getting the steaks, guys, we might have to go for the hot dogs.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, put a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
From midfield, here's Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. And it's knocked away and incomplete. The former first-round pick, Marlon Humphrey, there to get a hand on it.
Well, he leads the NFL in interceptions and nearly added to that total.
Got his hand on it, couldn't quite corral it. It's been a Pro Bowl-type season for him, and the term ball hawk really comes into play, doesn't it?
Yeah, I like that one a lot because teams want to avoid that type of a player, but sometimes you just can't. He just knows where the ball is.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down. From the gun, it's Mahomes. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. Got a man, it's caught. Inside the 10. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 50 yards. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. The extra point up and good. And that makes it a 21-10 game. Butker now to kick this one away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The Ravens' offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get 6.
Sit down, boy.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. An excellent way to start the drive there. 18 yards.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game, because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
It's a pickup of 11 at a Baltimore first down. Now it's Jackson stepping up. He's going to keep it. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Back-to-back 11-yard gains, and they've got another first down.
As a rookie quarterback, that's exactly how you endear yourself to your teammates. Give it up for the cause. It's also how you end up on the training table, too.
Yeah, it's a catch-22. Coach doesn't like it. Teammates love it. Where do you fall?
I fall on wanting to endear yourself to your teammates.
Hey, sit down, boy.
Be smart about it. They need you for the full season.
Yeah, the rookie's going to learn as he goes. Second down, Montgomery. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. Now, yes, a two-possession game, but a good chunk of time on the clock, so they have the ability still there to run it on second short, but maybe they need to pick it up a bit.
You're right, they did pick up the first down there, but they, as you mentioned, they have to pick up the pace now, because it's a two-possession game. They've got to get there twice to make sure they have a chance to win.
To throw on second down. Jackson. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball come in the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion. Kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you go make a play on the football.
From the gun on third down, Jackson. He's got Snead. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. And a 2-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified. Big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
Now here's a defensive timeout called by the Chiefs. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Line of scrimmage. Again, the 4-yard line. Second and goal. He'll get it up the middle. And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown.
Hey, sit down, boy.
His third touchdown now on the year. And the Ravens have cut it to within a score. Well, it was second and goal. You're in there close. That's the fullback's comfort zone.
Not only is it his comfort zone, it's an expectation. That's what he's supposed to do. Turn and hand it to him. Big guys fire out. Find your way into the end zone.
Now a toss coming right side. That's Collins. And he'll get into the end zone as the 2-point conversion is successful. Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. The ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it could be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. To begin the drive, here's a handoff to Hay. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. Eric Weddle brings him down.
All right, that's a decent game there, but it hasn't been his best game overall. So I wonder what the mindset is of this team. Do they want him to handle the football and try and close this game out? Or are they going to make an alternative plan and maybe go in a different direction?
I think they need him, and this is his time to shine. Flushed out right.
He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback in the backfield. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before
hey,
he
sit
can
down.
Get out of the backfield. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Shit.
Now look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, C.J. Mosley. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. A critical error there in a tight game of the fourth.
You talk about is taking care of the football, and especially with a lead here in the fourth quarter, turning it over. Now the door is open for the opposition.
Just in general, when you're passing in the fourth quarter with a lead, no matter at what point, you got to be super careful.
Got to be careful, and sometimes you can be so careful that you end up running yourself into an error.
On the give, this is their fullback. And able to get him inside the five here, just inside the five to about the four. And it's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. This is Collins on the handoff, and he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down to about the 2-yard line. A 3-yard pickup on second and four. Now they'll need to convert here on third and a little more than a yard. They'll go with the keeper. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the one. And the Chiefs are going to signal for and be granted another timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. They come out here in the and he'll get in. Touchdown, Baltimore. Lamar Jackson, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Ravens have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. Now Tucker to add the PAT. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful.
Sit down. Come on,
here's
baby.
Tucker now out to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. So now here are the Chiefs as their offense makes their way back out onto the field. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on
every week
in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late-game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Yeah, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. He's back to throw. Escaping the pressure right.
Come on, man.
Oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted.
God.
Picked off by Brandon Carr. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line.
wrong person.
And that one, oh, it's gonna hurt big time. You're in the 2 minute drill, trying to get
shit.
Your guys down the field.
Man. Damn.
Like they're gonna go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw, and it'll wind up being intercepted.
Victory seemingly in hand here.
Fuck.
Now we're gonna get a timeout here called by the defense. As the clock stops here with 46 seconds left to play. And they take a knee.
Good game, man. Good game. Fuck, man.
They're lining up to add three more, a little insult to injury here late in the game. He hit his first one, this from 44 yards out now. And that is no good. And this score will stay right where it is.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go.
Man, this shit crazy.
And this one winds up no good.
I ain't got no play for this shit, bro.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. One final try for Mahomes. And it's a yard or two, taken down behind the line.
Oh. Make up the bed. I lost a fucking good one.